This video is about the small town of Linthicum, Maryland, located in Anne Arundel County. In 1801, Abner Linthicum purchased a tract of land that would later become known as the Linthicum Community. The oldest surviving Linthicum home, Turkey Hill, was built about 1822 by William Linthicum and is still home to his descendants. The Linthicum family developed the town that is today a thriving crossroads and gateway to BWI, Thurgood Marshall Airport.
There are many churches in town. They are St. Philip Neri Catholic Church,
Linthicum Heights United Methodist Church, which includes Holly Run Church,
Linthicum Baptist Church, Holy Cross Orthodox Christian Church,
Linthicum Seventh-day Adventist Church, which also houses Andover Baptist Church, Full Gospel Mission Church,
St. John Lutheran Church, St. Christopher's Episcopal Church, which also houses Dayspring Presbyterian Church,
and Friendship Church of the Brethren.
The Anne Arundel County Historical Society is located in Linthicum at the Benson Hammond House. John Stoll is the docent there and a longtime Linthicum resident.
Favorite spot in Linthicum? I like the Holly Run Church. That little chapel, my forefathers worshipped in there. And it was, I believe, constructed in 1829. Originally was down Camp Meade Road and Belgrove Road, where I think a gasoline station is on that corner now. And it was later, when the property was sold, they disassembled the little chapel and moved it up into Linthicum on behind the Methodist Church.
Linthicum is home to Linthicum Elementary School, Overlook Elementary School, Lindale Middle School, Friendship Adventist School, and St. Philip Neri Catholic School.
G&M and the Olive Grove are two of the area's most popular restaurants. The community is also home to the Linthicum Luncheteria, which is only located in Linthicum. On the wall of the eatery is a plaque that lists the honorary mayors of Linthicum. Mr. Julius Jr. Tauber is our current mayor, and he owns a local towing company which was always a popular meeting spot in the community.
8 or 10 people here almost all the time, just discussing the weather and what else, you know. But there was always a bunch of people here.
The neighborhood spot.
Yeah. Uh-huh. In fact, the school kids used to come in here and go to school too. They used to wait here for a bus when I first came here. I used to have about 15 of them here. Wait for a bus.
There are many recreational activities in Linthicum. People enjoy duck pin bowling, the Andover Pool, Hoyt's Movie Theater, the BWI Hiker Biker.
They Camp Meade was developed, and they macadamized the road, the country road through Linthicum, all the way to Camp Meade for the soldiers. Linthicum proper, the homes in Linthicum proper, were most all built on some part of the 1,600 acre farmland owned by the Linthicum. And we built our house in 1940. And this area right now where my house is built and around, it has been designated as a historical trust.
Where the apartment house is, the large white apartment house is at Maple and Sweetson Road. When I was a child, the post office was located in the bottom of that. And then there was also a ballet studio, and many of us took fancy lessons there.
You asked if I had any one story, and the truth is No, I couldn't pick out any one thing, but I think there's a lot of stories in Linthicum, and the one that I just sitting here in the library, I could think of most is this building itself, how it got to be here. And back in the 50s, early 50s, the community was served by a bookmobile, and there wasn't a library. And even before that, there was no bookmobile, no library at all. There was a shelf of books at a store that occupied the train station that people could leave a book, borrow a book, you know, whatever, very, you know, very kind of informal. But in the around 1956-57, some people got together, Mrs. Shea and Doc Olbrecht and others, and raised money to and organized a lease of the B&A Railroad building for a library. And they involved the Sea Scouts did the painting, the community did the work on the walls and stuff, and they had themselves a really nice library there. And that was the first Linthicum library. It served the community up until the mid-60s. And I think that's an example of how this community works and what makes it a good place to be.
Linthicum is home to almost 10,000 people, but still maintains a friendly, close-knit atmosphere. It's a great place to live.
It's very convenient to stores, churches, hospitals, and businesses.
The quality of life, you get a small town feeling.
A wonderful mix of people.
Everyone blends well together. It's a perfect location.
Oh, right. That's it. Number one.
It's close. The network of roads gets you to Annapolis very quickly. It gets you to Washington very quickly. It gets you into the city very quickly. And it gets you north of Baltimore very quickly.
The best thing I ever did was settle in Linthicum and spend my whole life here, whole adult life, and still enjoy fellowship with people I went to school with, and as well as people from other states who settled here.
Wonderful place to live.